Have you ever wondered how houses on a really, really steep hill actually deal with their septic system? How do they run the pipe? Where's everything at? And how do they prevent all that excessive force from the water causing problems? Well, today I had a situation just like this, and I want to go into it and tell you how they dealt with it and what kind of unique things they used to deal with the problems of excessive force from the water. So the very first thing we have to discuss is, how big is this house? And on the side of the screen, I'm going to show you basically what I saw from when we start with the foundation to where we walk to the actual tank. So the home's about a 5-bedroom house, and it's on a very, very steep hill. Now, these types of homes do exist. We do live in the mountainous areas, or at least in Western Maryland we do. This particular tank, though, was set about a good 100 and some change feet from the house. And then beyond that, another 160 foot to the drain fields. So the reason they had to spread everything out was they were trying to get to more of the lower flat areas. So as we're walking from the house to the tank, we're gonna see these little pipes. Now, these little pipes are what we would refer to as cleanouts or snake lines. The purpose of these pipes is so that way, as you're flushing toilets, running sinks, bathtubs, if something gets stuck in the pipe, you're able to dislodge whatever it is. Most of your snakes that you use to dislodge clogs, you're not going to have as much force the further you get. So if you have a 120 foot run and you start all the way at the beginning, you may not have enough force to push whatever is blocking it at 119 feet. So in our area, we'll usually put one right at the foundation and then every 75 foot of piping from there on. So that way, depending on where the clog is, you can actually go ahead and dislodge it. So as we're walking down the hill, you're gonna see that we see a lot of these little 4-inch pipes. Now, we gotta deal with rocks in the mountains. So this pipe will actually kind of zigzag its way down to the tank. Anytime you make any kind of turns or bends, you run the risk of potential clogs. Plumbers don't usually like making bends because every bend you make, you could run into a problem down the road. So a lot of times we try to do straight lines. But in the mountains, you could run into problems where you just get a really big rock that you just can't avoid. So the best way to deal with that rock is you just kind of work around it. And this is where we actually make it to the septic tank, right? So this particular tank has a riser and a cleanout on it. The cleanout's gonna be that 6-inch PVC pipe, and the riser's gonna be that large green lid. Now, we've already discussed how septic systems work, and if you don't have a riser on your system, now's a really good time to go ahead and consider getting one put installed. The reason why is those risers really help to properly maintain the system by pumping out all of those nasty solids that'll work their way into the drain fields. So as we've walked our way down, we've seen that we've got quite an aggressive hill that we have to work our way through. So all that water is going to gravity feed into the tank. So as it falls, it starts to pick up kinetic force, which should push all of the solids and the water into the tank. As the water gets into the tank, the heavy stuff falls to the bottom, and then the lighter stuff floats on the top. And that's where you have your baffle. The baffle is going to prevent all that floating stuff from getting into the pipe and causing problems out of the tank. But you got to deal with the water somehow, and that's where the drain fields come into play. So this particular property has two drain fields. So as the water goes into the tank, the water will then spill over and into the distribution box. But remember, we're well over 100 feet away from the tank to the drain fields. So again, we got to worry about kinetic force, and the purpose of a distribution box, which we've covered previously, is to basically slow everything down so we can get nice dispersion into the drain fields evenly. You don't want too much water going into one trench primarily, because what can happen is you overload that system. An overloaded drain field could fail first, could fail prematurely. You could have an issue with water bleeding out of the back of it. You could also have issues with water surfacing up. And when I use the term water, I mean wastewater. Like, it's not actual like potable drinking water. It's that nasty stuff. You could also run into problems of the system just not flowing correctly and backing up. So you gotta deal with that force somehow. This particular property went ahead and used something called a surge box. Now, you might be asking, what is a surge box? And in short, essentially what it is where you have two distribution boxes. You have one in front of the other. And the purpose of the first one is to slow down that kinetic force so that way then it evenly flows into the second distribution box without just all plowing right into one of the trenches. It's not really something you see on a regular system. You'll almost always only see this on houses that have a really, really aggressive hill. And then obviously the drain fields are gonna do what normal drain fields do. They're just basically a trench. In our area, they're usually 2 or 3 feet wide, 6 or 10 feet deep, and then they'll roughly be 30 to 100 feet long. It really depends on your soil and your property makeup. This particular one has 50 foot trenches, so you got 100 feet total and they're 2 feet wide. So again, how this works, you flush the toilet, water will go down the pipe into the tank, tank will capture the solids, and then the liquid's gonna flow out of the tank and into the surge box, from the surge box to the distribution box, and then from the distribution box to the drain fields. Whenever you have a house like this, the odds of you ever noticing that it failed is little to none. And the reason why is that it's all gravity feed, right? If your drain fields decide that they want to stop working, well, water will always go where the path of least resistance is. If those drain fields fail, what'll happen is it'll just either surface or it'll start backing its way up to either a lid or the septic tank. And then from there, it'll just kind of spew out of the tank. So for houses like this, you don't really have to worry about it backing up into the home. If you do have a backup in your house, it almost always is a clog between the tank and the house itself. So like for example, if you're flushing feminine products or cigarette butts or flushable wipes, those things can get stuck in the pipes and can cause clogs, which can cause a backup towards the house. Now, if you have a more flat, low-lying area on your property for your septic system, well, if your drain fields decide that they want to fail, if it's easier for that water to back up to the utility sink or the bathroom toilet, that's probably where it's going to go, right? So there is a benefit to having a tank off the side of the hill. Now, what are some of the negatives? Maintenance is really going to be your problem. When you have to deal with pumping solids out of the tank, the pumper has to keep into account the height and the distance, and also the viscosity, so like how thick is the solids. So if you've got real thick septic system that you haven't pumped in 20 years and you're 400 feet away from that driveway, it's gonna get pretty difficult for that guy to pump out the tank. So it's very important to kind of think about how are you gonna maintain it when you're getting it designed. Most good installers will have that figured out prior to even breaking ground. Like they're not gonna install a system that couldn't be maintained. And if they did, they're probably not gonna be in business for very long because they're gonna cause a lot of problems. Usually whenever we see systems that aren't able to be maintained properly, it's because somebody put it in themselves and have never installed a septic system. It's kind of, I guess, what people want to do. So I thought that this was an interesting one. I don't come across it very often, so I wanted to share it with you. These types of systems, they exist, they're out there. And sometimes you can't do anything but work your way around a giant rock, or maybe you have a house on top of a hill and you got to deal with that sewage somehow. So if you found this enjoyable, if you found this entertaining or interesting in any way, hit that like button, hit subscribe. I have more videos posted every day on the World of Well and Septic, and I look forward to talking to you guys tomorrow.